Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon,
sir. Nice to see you all. And I hope everybody can hear me on a scale of 5 or 4 out of 5. So I have an electricity blackout, so maybe you guys will not be able to see me clearly, but you please follow my voice and whatever I'm sharing on the screen. Now, before we start, I would want you to just remind me what we did yesterday. Yesterday being our first class where we did flight plan, today we are going to continue, make some notes, and you know, get our definitions clear about the flight plan. So what I want from you guys is that you have to make physical notes in your notebooks using a pen and paper. So if you don't have it handy, then I would request you to arrange it. All right. Now, this technique of giving notes in class and you writing it down is one of the best techniques for you to memorize everything in the class itself. But we'll not use this technique for all the topics. We'll only use this technique for those topics which are solely based upon theory, which don't have any technical calculations, numericals, or something else like flight plan, or maybe performance. Okay. Now, what is a flight plan? Harshit, if you can tell me the answer. Abhipriti, can you tell me what is a flight plan?
Yes, sir. If someone wants to go from destination A to destination B by an aircraft, then they have to submit details about their flight prior to the ATC, because there might be a collision in the air. So the details that you submit to the ATC
is called flight plan. Okay. So details about your flight that you have to conduct, including your departure and arrival, has to be sent to the ATC before you perform. Okay. Mukul, can you tell us what is the importance of this flight plan and what are the other details that are there in the flight plan? Basically, can you define what is a flight plan?
Okay. Flight plan is a detailed information about a flight that's going to be conducted, and it's been filed by a pilot or a designated organization. So a flight plan generally includes a couple of items that are which the most important are 13 items. Generally comprises from item 7 to 19. So item 7 is aircraft identification. Then we have item 8 with flight rules, types of flight. Item 9, number of flights, type of aircraft, wake turbulence.
Good.
Item 10, equipment.
Good.
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry?
Sir, I couldn't attend the class yesterday.
Who's talking?
I'm Sushant.
Hi, Sushant. Hi. No problem, Sushant. Just make notes. No problem.
Will I get the recorded video of today's class?
Yeah. Yesterday's and today's class recorded video will be shared with you guys today. Because this topic will be finishing today itself. It's in two parts. So you don't worry about it. You will get the first lecture also. And today's session also, apart from the revision that I'm giving these students who had attended it, it is going to be independent of what we did yesterday. So don't worry about it. You will not miss anything. Whoever is attending it for the first time, you will not miss anything. Just wait and watch what is happening, okay? Yeah. So Jeet, can you tell me the importance of a flight plan?
The importance of a flight plan is that we avoid any traffic collisions, and it helps the ATC to better manage the flight environment. And they have all the necessary information to act on once they receive the flight plan.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You said something that says to avoid a collision. Of course, a flight plan is necessary so that, okay, the ATC can see your flight even before you have done it and make sure that no other flights will be going through your flight levels or your routes. One thing that we see in the flight plan, which is the most important thing, is the route. How will you fly from point A to point B, and what is the route? This route will mention all the points where you will be making certain changes, either the changes in your flight direction or the changes of your flight routes, IFR to VFR or VFR to IFR. So remember this point whenever you're writing the route part in your flight plan. Okay. The routes will be mentioned only at those points where you will be making any significant changes to your flights. Maybe your flight level, that is your altitude, maybe your direction, okay, or probably your flight routes. All right. Now, once again, I'm just saying this. Whoever did not attend the session yesterday, don't worry. You'll be getting the recordings for that and this both, and it will all connect with each other. So today's purpose is to get in detail when it comes to theory, to be able to answer your questions in the examination. So I'm going to give you a few important points that you have to listen and write it down. So I hope by now you have arranged. A notebook and a pen or a worksheet. If you're making digital notes, I hope you can type fast. I'll just give you a couple of minutes to arrange it. Just a sec, okay? So I'll just share the picture of the flight plan on the screen for everyone to see. Once again, the clear image of the flight plan and the notes from yesterday's class, everything will be shared to you via email as class notes. And you'll also be shared the link by end of day today. Tomorrow we'll have a break from navigation, so you'll get the time to study tonight and tomorrow. Now, this is the format of the ICAO flight plan. ICAO flight plan. This is what we are studying. It's a standard format document, which you need to, you know, study thoroughly because you will be filing it on a day-to-day basis in your real life also. This is exactly what you'll use in your real life. Almost everything that I'm going to teach you in all your subjects is going to be relative up to 90% to your real lives, because your theory is that important. And I'm going to teach you in that way and relate it with all your life experience that you're going to face in the future. So remember it, use it, and never forget it. That should be your intention when you're studying. You have to think about keeping the data permanent in your head. Now, one important thing that I have to add is that everyone, the flight plan has different item numbers. As you see on the screen, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13, 15, 16, 18. So from 3 to 18 is something that you as a PIC on a normal flight have to fill. The information which is after 18, that is 19 onwards, is subject to requirement based upon whether the aircraft is due for checks, due for maintenance, has there been an incident or accident, something like that. Although you will be made to file it on a daily basis and include the things in item number 19 also, but theory wise, you have to understand 19 is not compulsory unless otherwise requested by ATC. So write down, item number 18 onwards. What is 18? I'll just simply, you know, show you with color codes what is important and what is not. So what I'm marking in blue is the part from item 7. Item is nothing but a blank. Okay, this much is very important for you, only this much. The blue part, and it comprises from item 7 to item 18. Remember, we don't have item number 11 or 12 or 17. Correct? From 7 it starts, 7, 8, 9, 10, no 11 and 12, only 13, 15, and then 16, no 17 and 18. What will be the questions like? Questions will be like, what do you get in item 18? Or where do you get other information on the flight plan? The option you have to choose will be item 18 or other information depending upon the question. So this much part is very important, item 7 to 18. This part is supplementary information. You will not fill it unless otherwise requested by ATC. Remember this for your theory purposes. Okay. So yellow part is subject to requirement from ATC or certain times when the aircraft is due or not. And the part that I will show you in green is something that will be pre-filled on your flight plan. You know, the biggest agency in civil aviation is the European Aviation Safety Agency, EASA. Okay. And similar to EASA, there are multiple more aviation safety agencies, like there is FAA, that is Federal Aviation Administration. Then there is CAA or CAA, that is Civil Aviation Authority. Okay. And these regulate a larger amount of countries together when it comes to aviation. In India, we have DGCA India. Similarly, other countries also have DGCA. Their own respective DGCAs. The word DGCA is very common, not just Indian, but many. All right. So what I have seen is that the FAA, the CAA, and EASA, they all follow a training module, which is very modern in nature. But that is not yet implemented in our country when it comes to CPL ground studies. Very soon, Indian DGCA is also going to be converted into CAA. Proposals and revisions and drafts have been introduced. So sooner or later, we'll see the change happening. So I use the same method to train. Now, what happens is in these methods of training, although the quality over there is not as thorough as we do in our country, but what I've done is we will study topics on level basis. First level, we'll talk about the topic in a very simple common term. And the second and the subsequent levels will make us go deeper into the topic. And this is a very good way to study. All European master's courses are also taught like this. German and France and, you know, Amsterdam and everywhere else. So I want you all to benefit from it. That being said, whenever you see any doubts happening, write them in the last page of your notebook, that is a parking lot, so that you can discuss with me after the session or in person. So this is the flight plan. Now we are going to see a little bit of theory about the flight plan, for which you have to make your notes. So what is a flight plan? Write down the definition. It's your first time making notes with me, guys. We will go slow. If you're not able to keep up, let it be. And just follow my instructions. If somebody asks you, where do you get information about your ICAO flight plan, then you will say we get it in ICAO document 4444. That is very important. So ICAO has issued, what is ICAO? International Civil Aviation Organization. ICAO has issued a lot of recommended practices and documents, and they are numbered in a way for you to get information about rules and regulations of your aviation, commercial aviation journey. So very often you will see a lot of documents being asked to you, a name of documents, series, this and that, and regulations. But a couple of documents are also important when it comes to air navigation. And that is to do with your flight plan. You as a pilot don't only have to fly the planes, you have to keep yourself up to date with your currency and your education. That's why these questions are very important to you. So the first thing that you have to write about the flight plan is that the reference material for ICAO, ICAO flight plan is found in ICAO document 4444. That is the number of the document. And these questions, guys, you have to remember forever, because when the vacancies start coming after you have your CPL, anything and everything could be asked to you in your first round, which is a written paper for 100 marks. Second round, which is a Viva. Anything and everything could be asked to you. So the more you know and the more you remember, the more will be your chances to get a job. So ICAO flight plan reference we get from document 4444. And all your notes you make in points, okay? That's it. You can name your points, point number one, point number two, and so on. End of the session, I'll also share a copy of those notes with you, whatever I'm giving you. And try to compare our notes with the image of the flight plan that you see on the screen. Try to see where the item number 7 is, item number 8 is, item number 9 is, and so on. So anybody has any questions, please talk to me right now. Any doubts before we proceed ahead? Take a few minutes to talk back to me. Guys, remember, even if you don't have anything to say, you have to acknowledge, right? You have to say negative, no doubts, end with your call sign. So that I know at least you guys are listening to me. Because, you know, sometimes we can lose the connection.
I have a question. It's Mukul.
Mukul, use your call sign, Victor Tango, and three letters. VT, okay. Followed by three letters.
Okay. So it's Victor Tango, Mike India Echo.
Yeah. Hussein, I want you to also make a call sign. Use VT and any three letters that connect with your initials and use that as your name whenever we are studying. That will be a personal call sign. That is nothing but your aircraft registration marking code. So we'll assume that you have a private plane and that's the registration of that plane. So you'll represent yourself with that name. Everybody try to use that. Jeet, I want you to make one for yourself also. Okay. Whenever you give me a reply or acknowledgement, just end it with your call sign. It will really help you, you know, stay in touch with your RT exam practices also.
Sure, sure.
So my question is, since we are looking at individual flat plan, is it different from the repetitive flight plan, this format?
No, the format is not repetitive, but when you file a repetitive flight plan, now that is something that we are going to see, then you don't have to mention all the things. You have to mention things differently. So what are the things that you need to mention is something that we see. The whole point of having a flight plan, which is not individual, but repetitive, is that you don't have to repeat the same information again and again because it's already there. So we will see that. So the first thing you write down, point number one, ICAO flight plan references is in ICAO doc 4444. Okay, keep this strongly in your memory. Next, anybody wants to talk or discuss anything, please go ahead, please, please, please. Or just quickly say negative and with your call sign. So that I can proceed ahead.
Negative Victor Tango, Mike India Echo.
Negative doubt, Victor Tango.
Negative Victor Tango, Hotel Alpha.
All right. Now, what is a flight plan? Let's write the definition. What is an ATC flight plan? Write this down, and ahead of it, write what I'm giving you, the definition. What is an ATC flight plan? So the answer to this is very simple. It is simply advance notice of a pilot's intentions. It is simply advance notice of a pilot's intentions for a flight. In terms of route, including departure and destination, comma, cruising level and speed, and information about the crew and passengers. And information about the crew and the passengers. Was everybody able to get the information?
From Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo.
From Victor Tango Mike India Echo.
From Victor Tango Hotel Alfa Romeo.
Only three or four confirmations. And Victor Tango Hotel Alfa Romeo. It is not Rome, it is Romeo. Hussein, are you there with us? Can you acknowledge?
Yes, sir. Victor Tango Hotel Romeo Charlie.
Okay. Very good. Victor Tango Hotel Romeo Charlie. Got it. Okay. Sushant, please change your call sign. Sashank, please change your call sign.
Can you repeat after speed?
Yes, sir. I'm changing.
Good. When you have to ask me to repeat something, you can say again after speed. You can use the word say again and after speed and end with your call sign. Okay. Say again after speed. Yeah.
Yeah, again with the speed, sir.
Yeah. Say again after the speed. Sure. Cruising level and speed and information about the crew and passengers.
Thank you.
So what are the types of flight plan? Write down individual or repetitive. Now next point, types of flight plan, individual or repetitive. So there are two types of flight plans. It can be an individual flight plan or a repetitive flight plan. That's the basic categorization. Individual or repetitive. Types of flight plan, individual or repetitive. So as a student, you wouldn't really are required to know what are the type of the flight plan. Is it individual or repetitive? Then you're also required to know what is the format of an ICAO flight plan, like the item numbers. What is an item number? Nothing but which information goes onto which blank. It's a digital form with blanks Item number 7 has your aircraft identification and so on. We'll write them down once again. Okay. For people who don't know, just stay tuned and we'll write them down. You need to know the format. You need to know the information required for the flight plan. So in total, how much of information do we need? We need departure aerodrome, arrival aerodrome, aircraft identification, type of aircraft, equipment. So there are at least 13 information that you need spread across a few item numbers. 1, 3, 13. We'll see them right now. How to complete your flight plan, how to file your flight plan, how to cancel your flight plan, and how to amend your flight plan. These are the 4 things you need to be aware of. And that is where we will be done with our flight plan. So how to complete? That is something that happens on the computer. How to file, how to submit it to ATC. How can you cancel a flight plan that you have already submitted? And how will you make any changes to your flight plan that you have already submitted? Flight planning is your first step. After you learn how to fly a plane, even during your flight training, you will see that flight planning comes much before everything else. And most of your general aviation, general navigation that we will study, which is 50% of your navigation syllabus, deals with flight planning only. All right. So whatever you will solve or you have solved about tri-carrier angles, drift, ground speed, TAS, corrections, everything is to do with flight planning. Any questions, anyone so far?
Negative Victor Tango Papa Alpha Romeo.
Negative Victor Tango Mike India Echo.
Negative.
Now let's write a few dedicated definitions quickly. Write down definitions. Definition number 1, flight plan. Now this is again a description of the flight plan, but as per the definition, we'll quickly write them. And please do not worry about anything. This is just to help you all get started. If you have any queries, feel free to ask. Sir, aapke kya kara rahe ho? So what are you doing? We are not kids, this and that. Whatever comes to your mind, feel free to share with me. Okay. I always need feedback. But my suggestion would be just follow my instructions, go with the flow. And you will realize that once we reach a certain point, all the knowledge that you require and a little more is already stored in your brain automatically. So yeah, definition number 1, flight plan. The definition is specified information provided to air traffic service units. Specified information provided to air traffic service units. So I'm writing the definition of flight plan. The definition starts with specified information provided to air traffic service units, comma, relative to an intended flight or portion of a flight of an aircraft. Relative to an intended flight or portion of a flight of an aircraft. Jeet, can you give me a read back?
Specified information provided to air traffic units relative to an intended flight or portion of a flight of an aircraft.
Correct. Air traffic service units. It is air traffic service units. Very good. Whoever has missed, just tell me to say again. Okay. Next, repetitive flight plan, also known as RPL. Write down repetitive flight plan in brackets RPL. So, Abhipreeti, you tell me, if you had to define repetitive flight plan, can you give it a shot before we go ahead with the actual flight plan? I know it's a tough task, so there is no right or wrong answer to it.
I'll say for repetitive flight plan, the departure aerodrome, the arrival aerodrome, alternate aerodrome, and that will be same. The aircraft identification will be different. The pilot in command will be different. And most probably the equipment on board and the which rule they are using, that might be different. Yes, according to me, that.
Very nice.
And time of departure will be different.
Very nice.
And flight level will be same.
Okay. Good. Good to see the enthusiasm with which you gave the answer. Can anybody else try and tell me what a repetitive flight plan could be? See, this is the only time you'll get to guess, because I'm going to give you the actual answer, and after that you'll never give me any guesses. So it's always good to check whether your guesses are right or wrong, depending upon so much or however much you have, you know, understood so far. So Harshit, do you want to give it a shot? Yeah. Whatever you can say in your own words, all right?
Okay. It's like it's frequently reoccurring flight plans, basically a scheduled flight, which is occurring on a daily basis. So I guess for that, there is a repetitive flight plan.
All right. Okay, good. Hussein, do you want to share your answer? Harshit, that was a very nice answer, a generic answer. Your answer is correct. Abhipreeti is correct. All right, going good, guys. Hussein, please give it a try.
So basically, a flight plan for scheduled aircraft where on a monthly and a daily basis, the aircraft flies same route, so that there are certain information which are available. So
That's good.
Why we use repetitive flight plan.
Very nice. Thank you. Victor Tango, Mike Alpha X-ray, can you give me an answer?
I don't have any idea, sir, regarding this.
Can you guess?
Negative, sir.
Did you understand what is a flight plan?
Yes.
The general definition that we talk about the flight plan is nothing but your individual flight plan. Okay. Now what we're going to see is repetitive flight plan. All right. Everybody write down what is a repetitive flight plan or an RPL. Okay. A flight plan related to you can use abbreviation FP for your flight plan. Don't get confused, okay? So a repetitive flight plan is a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring. A flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated, frequently recurring or recurring, regularly operated individual flights. Now, this is where you should understand in the examination, you will see people playing with your mind, giving you three options for a definition of RPL. And all the three definitions will be similar with just one word changed in them. And that word could be individual. Okay, this is how important certain definitions are in navigation also. So a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated individual flights. Underline individual flights, everyone. With identical basic features. With identical basic features submitted by an operator for retention and repetitive use by ATC units. For retention and repetitive use by ATS units. Correction, ATS units. Okay, Victor Tango, Mike Alpha X-ray, I want you to give me a read back of this definition quickly.
A flight plan related to series of frequently repeated, regularly operated in individual flight with identical basic feature submitted by an operator for one word I am missing.
For retention.
And repetitive use by ATS.
ATS units. Okay, everyone, write down the second point for RPL. Now, this is a key factor in understanding RPL. Like you were trying to say, sir, this will be repetitive, that will be repetitive. There is a generic definition to it. What falls under RPL and what does not fall under RPL? There can come a definite question talking about it. And this is the next line that you're going to write. So the next point in RPL is, these flights must be operated on the same day / days. On the same day / days of consecutive weeks. So it means if I am proposing to fly on a Monday of this week, then if I'm filing a RPL, then the RPL should be such that even on next Monday, I have a similar flight taking place. And the next Monday and the next Monday. That's how the first connection we get in between RPLs or repetitive flight plans. So a flight plan, these flights must be operated on the same days of consecutive weeks and on at least 10 occasions and or at least on 10 occasions comma or every day over a period of at least 10 consecutive days. So these flights must be operated on the same day / days of consecutive weeks and on at least 10 occasions underline that, comma, or every day over a period of at least 10 consecutive days. So if you're going to fly the same flight for 10 days daily, then you can file a repetitive flight plan. If you're planning to fly, you know, on the same day in consecutive weeks, then at least you should have planned 10 flights of the same type. So maybe 10 Mondays, maybe a Monday and a Wednesday of every week. So you should at least have planned 10 flights to be able to file a repetitive flight plan. Okay, so the 10 is the number. If you have only 5 flights, then you cannot fly a repetitive, or you cannot file a repetitive flight plan. You need a minimum of 10 occasions that you have submitted your flight plan for, saying that I have planned as an operator. Who is the operator? The operator could be a PIC of a private plane, or the owner of an airline or the owner of a charter company or a designated representative of the operator. Okay, so don't get confused. The operator cannot always be PIC. It can be the owner, but the owner does not know all these things. So they hire a representative. The representative could be a flight dispatcher. So many, many pilots who are studying and waiting for a job act as flight dispatchers in certain airlines to gain experience, to make money and gain contacts before they can get into an airline. So that you can always consider for yourself also. The syllabus and everything for flight dispatcher exams is the same. Basically, what you do is just understand the weather, make flight plans and submit it. Also take care of load and trim sheet, of course. But for that, you have different people. Coming back to the topic, what is the second pointer? Who can give me a read back? The second point.
It's Victor Tango, Mike, India Echo.
Please go ahead.
These flights must be operated on same day or days of consecutive weeks and on at least 10 occasions or every day over a period of at least 10 consecutive days.
Very good. Anybody has any doubt, please ask.
Negative.
Who said negative now? Please end with your call sign.
I don't know how to change the name.
No problem. I will change it for you for now. What is the call sign that you're choosing?
Juliet Sierra Bravo.
Juliet Sierra Bravo. So remember it and use that. Okay. Juliet Sierra Bravo. Okay. So you can say negative. Victor Tango, Juliet Sierra Bravo. Basically, on the application Zoom, if you click on participants and if you click on your name, there is a button called More. In More, you can just rename. Victor Tango, Juliet Sierra Bravo. Okay, so now, is everyone sure about what a repetitive flight plan is and how to define it? Does anybody has any doubt? Guys, this is very important, okay? It looks easy, it might look boring, but it is important, so we have to go through it. Anybody has any doubt? Good. Let's jump ahead. If somebody asks you, what is a filed flight plan? What will you say? So write down, filed flight plan. F-I-L-E-D, filed flight plan. We just have, I think, 3 or 4 more definitions to go. Then we'll be done with definitions. And then quickly make notes about item numbers and we'll be done. Okay. So filed flight plan, FFP, filed flight plan. What is a filed flight plan? Write down. A filed plan, correction. We'll start again. Filed flight plan. The flight plan as filed When you hear the word filed, it means submitted to ATC, okay? So what is a filed flight plan? The flight plan as filed with an ATS unit. ATS full form is Air Traffic Service. The flight plan as filed with an ATS unit by the pilot or a designated representative. Without any subsequent changes. The flight plan as filed with an ATS unit by the pilot or a designated representative without any subsequent changes. Shashank, can you give me a read back?
1 minute.
So it is submitted or filed with an ATS unit by a pilot or a designated representative without any changes. That is the key here. Yeah, please go ahead, Sashank, quickly.
So the flight plan as filed with an ATS unit by the pilot or a designated representative without any changes.
Without any subsequent changes.
Without any subsequent changes.
Great. Anybody has any doubt with pilot flight plan?
Negative Victor Tango Papa Alpha Romeo.
Yes, sir. I didn't understand what is the meaning of without any subsequent changes. Victor Tango Alpha Bravo.
So what happens is, whenever you are filing a flight plan, it is on based upon the estimates about which altitude is favorable, which route is favorable, how is the weather, and everything else. How many passengers you're going to carry. And you can submit the flight plan well in advance, not just an hours before, but days before also. Now, when you're going to conduct the flight, say I had filed my flight plan a week ago thinking I'll carry 4 passengers on board. And I have to fly on a cruising altitude of, say, 20,000 feet. That is flight level 200. And I've selected, say, route Alpha 474. And my time to flight is, say, 1 hour. As total estimated elapsed time, TEET. And today, before flight, I realize that I cannot fly at that flight level because of bad weather, but I have to choose a higher flight level or a lower flight level. If I change my flight plan before my flight, then that will not be a filed flight plan. But if before my flight, I'm not making any changes whatsoever and everything going as per the plan that I had submitted a week before, then this flight plan that is with the ATC that I've already filed is known as filed flight plan. So it is a filed flight plan. It means the plan that I had made to fly a week before is what I'm going to go with. There have been no changes whatsoever. This is the key to understand. Similarly, when I show you something known as the current flight plan, then current flight plan is something that has changes. So this is the difference. So your current flight plan will be a filed flight plan if there are no changes from a week before and from today. But if there are changes, then your filed flight plan changes to your current flight plan.
Roger.
Anybody has any doubt? Understood, right? It was a good question. Okay, after file flight plan, please write down current flight plan. In between, if you guys want to talk to me, please raise your hand on the application. I can see or write down on chat so that you don't have to interrupt me also and I don't miss your doubts also. Current flight plan. Everybody write about current flight plan. Now, what is the current flight plan? The flight plan, including changes, if any, brought about by subsequent clearances. The flight plan, including changes, if any, brought about by subsequent clearances. I'll repeat it once again. It means I say again. The flight plan, including changes, if any, brought about by subsequent clearances. So this is exactly what we were talking about. If there are any changes, due to any other clearance. The clearance could be because of the change in weather. It could be because ATC wants it to change it. It could be because you want to carry one more passenger. It may be because you want to change the route. Maybe you want to change the destination. Then that becomes your current flight plan. If there are no changes, then your current flight plan is as same as your filed flight plan. But if there are changes, then your filed flight plan becomes your current flight plan. Okay, this is a simple definition, simple understanding. If you guys cannot follow it, please let me know. Pavani, can you give me a read back of current flight plan?
Yes, sir. The flight plan, including changes, if any, brought by subsequent clearance.
Good. Now, last three important definitions, guys. Let's try to finish them in 5 minutes. Estimated elapsed time, that is EET. Estimated elapsed time. It is an important part of your flight plan. Estimated elapsed time. Write down the definition. Estimated elapsed, E-L-A-P-S-E-D, elapsed time. I'll just tell you all the meaning first and then we'll write the definition. It is the estimated time duration that you think will be elapsed or consumed or you will spend when flying from A to B. But when you're talking about departure and destination, that EET becomes total EET, estimated elapsed time. This is an estimate of time. You have to stick to this estimate to reach your destination on time. Okay, this is an estimate. This is not the actual time spent because you have not yet carried out the flight. So don't be confused. This is a very important element. Like I said, even yesterday, EET is the only, this is the only place you'll talk about EET and CEET. No, nowhere else it is mentioned. And if it comes in your examination, I don't want you to be surprised. When I talk about EET, it is not the total time estimate, but a part of it, because the total time estimate will be represented as TEET, total estimated elapsed time. So this is EET, and write down the definition, EET, that is estimated elapsed time. The definition is the estimated time required to proceed, the estimated time required to proceed from one significant point to another. The estimated time required to proceed from one significant point to another. Guys, what is a significant point? These are those points on your route where you make changes. The changes could be changes to your altitude, changes to your route direction, changes to your flight rules. Remember, those are significant points. This definition also you will not get to discuss anywhere else. So if anybody asks you what are significant points, you say significant points are those points where you make changes to your flight, maybe in terms of altitude, maybe in terms of directions, or maybe in terms of flight rules, changing from IFR to VFR or VFR to IFR. Any doubts? Estimated elapsed time?
Negative, Victor Tango Papa for Romeo.
Negative, Victor Tango Mike, India, Echo.
Prashant, can you give me a read back? Shant, are you not there?
Sir, me?
Victor Tango Mike Alpha X-ray, is it Shushant?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, yes. Read the back of estimated elapsed time.
Okay, the estimated time required to proceed from one significant point to another.
Very good. Guys, estimates. Everything that you do in a flight plan are nothing but estimates. Although they are accurate, but they are estimates. The second term that the second last term in terms of our definition is estimated off block time. Now, this is an important question for navigation and important question for regulations also. Estimated off block time, also known as chocks off. And there is a huge debate that you will see in your circle of aviation talking about what exactly is the definition of off block time or chocks off. So this estimated chocks off or off block time is the time that you estimate that you'll start moving the airplane. Okay. What are chocks? Chocks are rectangular rubber solids that you place in front of your wheels, landing gears, nose wheel and main wheel, front and back, so that the aircraft does not move with air or any slope if there is. So it is very important. When you're doing pre-flight checks before the departure of an airplane, all the checks are done with the chocks on. Everything is done. When everything is right and you're ready to go, ready to commence your flight with a pushback or a startup, that's when you will remove the chocks. That is the last thing that the ground handler will do for you as a pilot. And when the chocks are off, he will give you a heads up and then you'll request for pushback and startup and go ahead taxiing to the runway for departure takeoff. So the definition of estimated off block time is the time estimate that you have given to ATC when you think your blocks will be off. It means that is the time when you will start moving the airplane. So your passengers, passenger embarkment and your fueling of the aircraft, before every flight the fueling will happen, cabin crew, flight crew, all the checks, extended transit, this and that will happen before your off block time. Okay, everything will happen before your off block time. So estimated off block time, write down the definition. It is, okay, just write down the definition. The estimated time at which, the estimated time at which the aircraft will commence movement associated with departure. I'll say again, the estimated time at which the aircraft will commence movement associated with departure. Now, movement associated with departure is the keyword here. In the examination, they will play with this term, replace it with other terms and see whether you know the difference or not. So what is estimated off block time? The estimated time at which the aircraft will commence movement associated with departure. I want somebody to be proactive and give me a read back and end with your call sign.
The estimated time at which aircraft will commence movement associated with departure. Which time will Bravo.
Roger, Mumbai ground. Great. Any doubts here? Any doubts, anyone?
Negative. Victor Tango Mike India.
Negative. Victor Tango Julius Sierra Bravo.
Negative. Victor Tango Mike Alpha X-ray.
Negative Victor Tango Papa for Romeo.
Negative Victor Tango Hotel Romeo Charlie.
Negative Victor Tango Hotel Alpha Romeo.
Guys, please use some energy, okay? Don't let the subject drain you. Your intent should be to drain the subject. No matter how boring, how difficult, or how lengthy it is, you should not let the topic or the subject overpower you and make you lose energy and get you bored and make you sleepy. You cannot give that authority to your subject. You have to master the subject. You have to sit on top of it and rule it. Like, yeah, I have ruled this. I rule navigation. I rule flight plan. It should be like that. Okay, keep that attitude. I know it will be difficult to keep yourself motivated at times, but you need to remember that, okay, I need to do this. I need to sit on top of it and master it and rule it and say, I'm the king of air navigation. I'm the queen of air navigation. That should be your attitude, all right? Don't get defeated by these things. These are very easy. And all your syllabus for CPL is nothing but ABCD of English language. It is very basic. It is very basic. You might not know it, But with experience, once you have cleared your papers and everything else, you will realize this is basic. There's much more to learn, but your basic is the building block. It's like grammar in English language. If you don't know all this, then in future, you'll have problems learning more, and that will impact your growth as a pilot. And whenever there will be a future recession, you will be the first one to pushed out of the company. So in order to grow and make your place secure for the rest of your life in an airline, you have to grow on every 2-year basis. And things like this will help you to connect, to make you connect with the management, operations department, to see you be a part of your training team, to see you be a part, someone who can be a check pilot. So you have to get those qualifications along with your CPL job so that, you know, your chances of being in the airline and much more. So you always have to be a student and a teacher, both when you become a pilot. You have to have those traits that you can teach your students or your friends or your colleagues, as well as you can learn from your colleagues and subordinates. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to survive even though you get a job, because every 10 to 15 years, you'll see a recession happening in aviation. Jobs will go, jobs will come, jobs will go, jobs will come. How do you determine that you will stay in the top of the pyramid? Your knowledge, your behavior, and everything else in the airline. You cannot just be an employee. You have to be a part of the management also. Then whenever you're flying, you will have to save fuel. So you need to know the engine, the technical aspect. What is specific fuel consumption? You need to understand weather. Where do you find jet streams where you can save a lot of fuel? Every time you'll fail, you'll save even 30 minutes of fuel or 15 minutes of fuel for an airline. You'll become on the top of the list of the airline. They'll give you more flights, better flights, longer flights. That is nothing but promotion. They will put you from a single aisle plane to a multi aisle plane. They'll put you from a Boeing 737 to a Boeing 777. All this is in your hand, all right? You cannot wait 5 years to be promoted from co-pilot to PIC. You want that in 2 years. How do you do that? You don't just want to fly domestic, you want to go international also. How do you do it? Only your knowledge. And knowing that you have to study on a regular basis, no matter where you are, not just for your ground papers, but in future also. Write down the next and the last definition for today. That is estimated time of arrival, ETA. This again is very important for you to calculate, because on your destination aerodrome, so you're flying from Mumbai to Delhi, based upon the ETA that you submit, that is a part of your EET, your total EET, the air traffic controllers at your destination will be expecting you and be making arrangements for your arrival in terms of air traffic controllers, other planes, departure approval for other planes. They will wait for you to arrive as per your estimated time of arrival. If you don't arrive, then their whole schedule and arrangement of sending different people will go haywire. So write down estimated time of arrival in bracket ETA. The short form is ETA. Start the definition. For IFR flights, IFR will be in capital, India Foxtrot Romeo, IFR. For IFR flights, comma, the time at which it is estimated that the aircraft will arrive over that designated point, comma, defined, defined, defined by reference to navigational aids, comma, from which it is intended that an instrument approach will be commenced. If no navigational aid is associated with the aerodrome, comma, the time at which the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome. After comma, the time at which the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome. I want everyone to give me a read back together on a count of three. All right, I want everybody to give me a read back together like we are sitting in one classroom on a count of three. One, two, three.
For IFR flights, the time at which it is estimated that the aircraft will arrive over that designated point defined by reference to navigational aids, from which it is intended that an individual instrumental approach will be commenced, or if no navigational aid is associated with the aerodrome, the time at which the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome.
I could make out only three or four voices, but I'm hoping everybody took a part in the activity. If not, then I highly encourage you should do it, guys. Don't be shy. Okay. All the tips and techniques. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, can you say again after the navigation lanes is associated?
Jeet, can you continue? Can you do that for me? Or if no navigational aid is associated?
Associated with the aerodrome, the time at which the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome.
Repeat again after the aerodrome.
Associated with the aerodrome, comma, the time at which the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome.
Thank you.
Great. Guys, this can be tricky if you don't understand. Okay. ETA, it can mean two things. Before that, you see the word navigational aids. What are navigational aids? They are instruments and systems made up of radio waves and electronics and electricity combined. They are transmitters and receivers that help you find directions. Those are what we call as radio navigational aids. Sometimes you can also get visual navigation aids also, something that you look at and land. Okay, like your runway is your visual landing aid, basically. If you can see the runway, you have to land at the runway. That is a part of your VFR. But we don't assume runway as an aid because it's not aiding us. It's just showing us where we have to land. So other instruments which help us reach, like your GPS. Now, GPS on your phone always helps you reach your destination. But it is so difficult to find the destination based upon GPS because you have to look around and then finally. So GPS helps you reach near your destination. But in aviation, we have better instruments wherein if you reach that point, it will help you reach that point definitely in terms of directions. And from there, you will be either asked to, you know, commence your descent. That is what they mean here by instrument approach, like ILS. Now, ILS is your instrument landing system that you will learn. It has certain elements which help you, you know, determine whether you're going as per the safe altitude of descent to reach the proper touchdown point on the runway, and whether you're maintaining the center line of the runway or to avoid any undershoot or overshoot of the runway. So there are many equipments to this ILS, like marker beacons, glide slope, localizer, and so on. All this you will learn when we do ILS. So what is ETA? So for IFR flights, when I say IFR, it means those flights that work mainly upon instruments and not on the visual reference of the pilot. So the pilot will not look outside and decide what he has to do, but the pilot, she will decide whether she has to, she'll decide everything based upon her instruments only. She really does not have to look anywhere outside the aircraft when she is flying IFR. So ETA for IFR is something that the time at which you estimate. So like, assume that today we decided to depart at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, that is 1300. And our estimated time of arrival was 1415. Then what does it mean? It means that at this present time, 1415, we had assumed or we had estimated we'll reach this ILS marker beacon of this airport at Mumbai from Delhi. And if I've reached here, then I have reached at my ETA that was scheduled. And now I'll commence my instrument approach. Now I will land. That is the meaning of the first sentence, which says for IFR flights, the time at which it is estimated that aircraft will arrive over that designated point. It could be any point. It could be a VOR station. VOR is very high frequency omnidirectional range. It is a different instrument. Every major airport is situated or located. You know, it's given a VOR because VOR is the most dependable radio navigation aid. But VOR can also help you for landing, also known as VOR approach. Or you will always use ILS or MLS for your landing. These are three navigational aids that help you with landing also. Other navigational aids will help you reach from one point to another, aerodrome to aerodrome, aerodrome to significant points to aerodrome, like that. So approach aids are different. Navigational aids are different. Approach aids are a part of navigational aids. So for IFR flights, the time at which it is estimated that the aircraft will arrive over the designated point, it could be any point, which will be defined by reference to any navigational aid from which the pilot or the operator has intended that they will commence an instrument approach. Instrument approach means you don't have to look at the runway. You look at the landing instruments to land. That's why you see so many videos that you guys see on Instagram. The pilots are just, you know, during the landing, they're sitting casually and just playing with the control column of an Airbus, or a stick of the Airbus, or the control column of a Boeing. And they're just doing this. With the one hand, they're doing this. One hand on the engine. What are they doing actually? They're not looking at the aerodrome. They will not be able to get this accuracy looking at the aerodrome. Okay? They are looking at the instruments, and the instruments are something like this. Landing instruments. Okay? This is something that you will learn. You have to learn for your navigation. One pointer will be like this. One pointer will be like this. All you need to do is just keep this in center. Keep this in center, horizontal center, vertical center. So the thing that you see, they are shifting like this, is basically because this is happening like this. So they just keep moving it. The sensitivity is very close, and you just keep it in the center. If you keep it in the center, if you keep a check on your altitude, and this also helps you with the altitude also, glide slope and everything. Everything happens here during your landing. If your plus is maintained using your control columns, and your thrust setting is the way it should be, your approach speed, then automatically you will touch down on the runway at the correct place. Automatically. This is the benefit of doing IFR. The chances of errors are reduced, although it is scary to know that you don't have to look at the runway at all. All right? Initially, you can spot the runway. Even if you don't, if you're tuned into the proper frequencies of the landing instruments, then the instruments will guide you accurately to the runway touchdown point. This is what the meaning is, estimated time of arrival for IFR point, IFR flights, that you reach to at that point from where you'll commence an instrument approach. That is ETA for your IFR flights. And if you don't have landing instruments or designated points, then how do you determine ETA for IFR flights? Maybe the landing for an IFR flight, the pilot will have to do a visual landing. It is possible you fly IFR, but landing has to be visual. If that is the case, then the pilot will have to see whether he or she can see the runway and the runway lights and the runway markings before landing. Only then he or she will do the landing. If that is the case, then your ETA will be the point, the estimated time when you are estimating that you'll reach over the airport. Then look for the runway in sight and then align and land. So this is your ETA for IFR flights, right? Just talking about ETA today, you learned so much about how approaches are made. What is it that you're going to learn in future in your navigation syllabus? So don't think that, okay, we are not learning anything. This is a basic thing and all. Trust me, if I don't take you through these definitions, you will never actually go through these definitions and you'll lose a mark or two in the examination, no matter how many notes I give you. Because I know it's not motivating at all. And that's my job to teach you. And then you can always revise. If I have to just give you notes and make you study on your own, then what's the point of you studying with me, right? So I'm making you study. So I want you to be a part of all these activities that I'm doing. Different techniques for different topics. That's my strategy. We have many techniques. So continue a definition, leaving a line, and write down ETA for VFR flights. This is where we will culminate our session. All right. So for VFR flights, write down everyone. ETA for IFR flights, we know. What is the ETA for VFR flight? Very simple. I think you all can guess already, but let's just write it down. For VFR flights, comma. Commas help you understand lengthy sentences, all right? That's why I specify. For VFR flights, comma, the time at which it is estimated. For VFR flights, the time at which it is estimated the aircraft, it is estimated the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome. For VFR flights, the time at which it is estimated the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome. That is the ETA for VFR flights. That is. So your ETA does not mean in any way the time of landing. Remember this, okay? Your ETA does not mean in any way the time of landing, but the time of arrival either over the aerodrome, okay, or the arrival at a significant or a designated point based upon navigational aids from where you'll commence your instrument approach for IFR flights. Or if no instrument approach, then over the aerodrome for IFR flights also and over the aerodrome for VFR flights also. It is like that. It is not the time when you will be parked in your parking bay and the passenger disembarkment will start. No, that is not your ETA. ETA is not your touchdown point also. All right. ETA is either the time when you reach over the aerodrome or a designated point from where you will initiate your instrument approach. All right. Remember this. So your ETA, you will always give your ETA in your position reports to your air traffic controllers over your RT. That will not mean the time of landing or reaching the aerodrome on ground, but over the aerodrome in air or over the point from where you will initiate your instrument approach. And now you know a little bit about instrument approach. Okay. So Victor Tango, Mike, India, Echo, do you have any questions? Have you understood everything correctly?
Negative, sir. Victor Tango, Mike, India, no questions.
And negative for understanding also, is it?
Yeah.
It means you have not understood anything. Because negative means understood. No.
For understood, it's affirm.
Okay.
And good. For any good. Queries, it's negative.
Good. I understand what you meant, but you know, in RT, in aviation, we don't make guesses. You're just learning. So yeah, good. Victor Tango, Alpha Bravo Hotel, do you have any doubts? Did you understand everything?
Negative doubts and I understood everything.
Victor Tango, Hotel Alpha Romeo, how about you? Any doubts? Did you understand everything?
Negative. Yes, sir.
Victor Tango Papa Alpha Romeo, same question.
Affirm, I understand everything. Negative, no questions.
Victor Tango Mike Alpha X-ray.
Negative.
Negative for both?
Sorry?
Negative for doubts or negative for understanding?
Negative for doubts.
How about understanding?
Affirmative.
Very good. Try to use affirm, not affirmative, short it to affirm. Victor Tango, okay. Juliet, Sierra, Bravo.
No doubts. Affirm for understanding everything.
Victor Tango, Hotel, Romeo, Charlie.
Negative for doubts. Affirm for understanding.
Victor Tango, is everyone done? Am I missing someone? Victor Tango Alpha Hotel Romeo, correction, Hotel Alpha Romeo. Doubts and understanding?
Negative for doubts.
How about understanding?
Affirm, sir.
Great. All right, wonderful. So, Jeet, please tell me in your own words or the definition, try to say it first and then check your notebook. Definition of RPL.
Basically, they are recurring flights which need a period of which should be happening like on 10 occasions or consecutively every day over a period of 10 days. And most of the information on it is unchanged. And yeah.
Okay. Same day or days of consecutive weeks on at least 10 occasions is the accurate answer. Same day or days on consecutive weeks with a minimum 10 occasions or minimum of 10 flights consecutively in sequence. That will be eligible for RPL. All right. That is the more accurate and correct answer than what you gave. Your answer was right. Thank you. You need to just make sure it is completely accurate. Remember, everything that I'm teaching you, you cannot compromise and learn only 80%. So if today you have learned 60%, 70%, 80%, that is amazing. With revision, you have to make it 100%. All right. I will give you revision times. You have to use it for your revision. Okay. You all want to pass. I know it's a big struggle, but you have to follow the instructions. That was a good answer. Thank you. Always the first question is difficult one. Abhipreeti, Victor Tango Alpha Bravo Hotel, please tell me what do you mean by a filed flight plan?
Yes, sir. A flight plan which is filed to ATS unit without any subsequent changes made.
Good. Correct. Anytime if anybody thinks that the answer given by one of the pilots or the aircraft right now in the session is incorrect or wrong, you can always openly debate, openly challenge and say, sir, I would like to add. Of course, not disrespecting anyone, but it has to be a little competitive also. So you feel free if you notice any errors, always be on the lookout of mentioning errors. All right. Mike, India Echo, what do you mean by off-block time or estimated off-block time?
Estimated. The time, the estimated time at which aircraft will move from associated with departure, will make a movement with associated with departure.
Very good. Very good. All keywords are mentioned. Very nice. Anybody thinks not mentioned, feel free to just share your inputs, all right? Very good. Victor Tango Papa Alpha Romeo.
Yes, sir.
What is the ETA for VFR flights?
Sir?
ETA is estimated time of arrival. ETA for VFR flights.
Sir, I didn't understand the question. Can you repeat again?
What is the ETA, estimated time of arrival, for VFR flights?
For VFR flights.
Try to recollect in your memory. If you cannot find it, then you can go through your notes.
It is the time at which it is estimated the aircraft will arrive over the aerodrome.
Correct. Simple. Simple answer. Good. Victor Tango Hotel Romeo Charlie, can you tell me the definition of current flight plan? Always first try to give the answer in your own words and then check it with your notes and then mix it and then give the correct answer. No problem.
So the current flight plan is basically a flight plan which has changes to it from the filed flight plan.
If you have to use the keywords as per the definition, it would be a flight plan having subsequent changes, if any, based upon clearances, current clearances or clearances. Correct? Go through your definition and see if you have any doubts, guys. Who's left to give me an answer? Victor Tango, Hotel Alfa Romeo. Can you tell me where do you get the references from for ICAO flight plan filing and changing and amending and everything? Is it in ICAO document 9896, ICAO document 4444?
So ICAO document 4444.
Correct. Correct. I was going to give you three options, but you got the answer because you knew the answer. Good. Okay, one more minute, guys. Do you have any doubts? Anyone wants to share anything about what we have studied or what we are going to do?
So, Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo.
Go ahead.
So what is estimated time of arrival? Can you explain it again?
It is the assumption that you make before your departure when you're filing your flight plan that I will reach there, my destination, or a designated point near the destination at this time of the hour or the day. It will be the time when you will reach there. So if I'm planning to take off or leave my airport at 9 a.m. in the morning, then my estimated time of arrival can be 10 a.m. to my destination. So that 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., in between what you get is your EET or total EET, and the time at which you will reach on clock, that is what we call estimated time of arrival. So it will be time in hours, AM or PM or 24 hours. It is like, okay, Pavani, I'm leaving my house now and I will reach your office at 3 PM. So when I say 3 PM, that becomes my ETA. All right. So it is defined in two ways for IFR flights and VFR flights. So if this is my aerodrome, this is my tower on the aerodrome, this here, my thumb. And this is my departure point, okay, for my plane. And if I'm departing at 9 a.m., and if I have already estimated my ETA, and my ETA is 10:30 a.m. to reach here, destination thumb. So I know I will leave at 9 a.m. and I'll reach at 10:30 a.m. So that 10:30 is my estimated time of arrival. Well, what will it mean? It will mean that I have flown for 1 hour, 30 minutes. The moment I reach here, I have estimated that I'll reach over the aerodrome at 10:30 a.m. For VFR flights or those flights where there are no instrument landing approaches, navigational aids, And for places where we get a navigational aid, wherein, you know, we land as per the instruments, considering this is the runway, then the point when you reach this point from where you tune and follow the landing aid for IFR flights. So that will be your ETA. So if you say my ETA is 10:30, then you will be expected to reach at this point at 10:30 a.m. by the destination ATC. You have to be here because that landing slot will be yours. Then they will give you a landing permission for say 10:31, 10:35, or maybe 10:40, depending upon whether you arrive on time or not. So it is the time when you will reach your destination, either over the aerodrome or the navigational aid point from where you will commence your instrument approach. Is everybody clear?
A form understands.
Anyone else has any doubts or wants to share anything?
So one more thing.
Mm-hmm.
So you have told us to underline some few things, which is very important. That means, can you explain it? What are the importance of the underlined words which you have said?
So, for example, the importance is this, that the first word that I used, I asked you to underline, was for RPL.
Yes.
Wherein we said a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated individual flights.
Yes.
The word individual is important because generally in your repetitive flight plan, you will not associate it with individual. Common sense will be that repetitive flights will be something that you will have in your mind. And it will impact you when you get options wherein the question will be RPL is, then you will be given three options. Option A, a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated repetitive flights. Option B, a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated individual flights. And yeah. Option C will be a flight plan related to a series of frequently recurring, regularly operated individual or repetitive flights. So over there, everything will be the same apart from the keyword that you have underlined. One option will have repetitive, the second will have individual, the third will have individual and repetitive. This is an example of the type of questions you will be subjected to in your examinations and the confusions in the options. So here you have to understand, although the definition is for RPL, RPL talks about consecutive individual flights taking place on a regular basis.
Yes.
It cannot be filed for a group of flights, it means. It can only be filed for single flights that are going to repeat on a regular basis based upon either 10 consecutive days or 10 occasions on a weekly basis going on the same day. That is the whole difference. You cannot file a group flight plan. It has to be for individual flights. And individual is the correct one. So the same can be done for other keywords also that we have underlined. Are you guys clear? See, I cannot see all. Everybody's video is off. So I don't really know if you guys are eating, sleeping, drinking, or studying or following. Okay. Although I recommend you all to keep your videos on when the lecture is on. But I won't force you all to do it again and again. If you're smart enough, if you are comfortable enough, you should do it. If not, I respect that. But I need some acknowledgement going on, either positive or negative. Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo, are you clear with the understanding?
A form. Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo.
Good. Anybody else has anything to ask or discuss? Jeet, anything?
Negative.
Mukul.
Victor Tango.
Negative.
Harshit.
Victor Tango Mike India.
Negative, sir.
Hussain.
Negative, sir.
Shushan.
Negative, sir.
Abhipreti.
Negative.
Great. Good, guys. So, This evening, you will get an email to the recording. And by tonight, you will get notes on flight plan. There will be more things in your notes, discussing item numbers and all. People who have attended the first session, of course, you know, so the notes will be easy for you. Those who have not attended, please first go through the first lecture recording. We have had a session for around 1.5 hours. Skip and check. Initially, 10 minutes always go, you know, in connecting and establishing and waiting for everyone to join. Take your time. Maybe you can increase the playback speed from 1 to 1.5 if you think it's a little slow. But don't skip anything. Just go through it because you have to attend that first class because you have missed it, some or the other reason. And then go through the notes. I'll give you one day. I'm going to, you know, make you understand what's the trend going to be. So tomorrow you will have an off for navigation. Tomorrow is the time when you have to thoroughly revise the notes again. Use the videos if you want to. Day after tomorrow, I'm going to give you a test. Now in the notes, there will be a few things that I've not verbally discussed with you, but the notes will be simple to understand. So don't discount them. The test will be in the form of MCQs. Okay, it could be 10 mark, it could be 20 mark, it could be 30 mark. And I'll give you the test live, sitting with me. Later on, as we proceed ahead, the tests will be given to you for you to solve on your own. But because we are getting used to all this, I want to give you an experience, see whether you understand or not. We'll be doing it live. Do not worry about the test. If you don't know how to answer, you can always go through your notes and answer. But that should be a secondary option. Initially, I would want you to have an open book test with me because my motive is to make you remember and understand and not check whether you have understood or not. So the purpose of everything will be to make you remember and understand and not to check whether you have understood or not. The check will come after 15 days or so when I'll give you a proper test, which will be a closed book test. Now the plan is good. Your involvement is necessary. Your regular involvement is necessary. Please don't fall back. Many people fall back, you know, they take it very lightly. And when the exams come, they are not prepared and they miss a session. I'm going to finish your syllabus quickly, not stretch it for 3 months or 2 months. Try to do it before that for navigation in a very efficient way. No shortcuts, but the things that are very important. But you have to be honest and you have to be hardworking. Okay. And I'm always here if you have any challenges. So you have to keep me in the loop. Study, remember, and you will see very quickly, you will be thorough with navigation and it will be very easy for you to answer questions in navigation. You'll feel good about it. You'll feel as if you're already a pilot preparing to fly. And once you have done good, maybe I can offer you some simulation sessions, but we'll see how we will go about it later in future. So please perform, please study. Keep me in the loop whether you have studied or not. And any doubts, any challenges, feel free to discuss with me, okay? I want you all to crack your exams in your next first attempt that you're giving. So that being said, guys, see you. And day after tomorrow, we'll have another session. Same time for navigation. I'll send the confirmation as usual. But keep that in your calendar right now. Thank you for joining and I'll see you all tomorrow. Day after tomorrow.